Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of City Skylines. If you've been enjoying the series and you like these videos, don't forget to leave a like, it does make a difference. As always, thank you for doing so and I hope you enjoy today's video. In this one, I got a feeling we might get a lot done. I don't know, I've just got a lot on my mind right now. So one of the overall objectives I want to get to this city is to initialize some public transport in the form of the tram around the outside. This track has been here forever and we're hardly utilizing it. And I was just going around and looking at the connections. We've actually sort of developed our city a little bit into it over here, which wasn't the original plan. As you can see, some of the roads connect and they use it, but the traffic on it is very minimal. Then there's no connections all the way up here, and then at the end of these roads there's these connections, and no one really comes out here and uses this road. And now I've sort of fixed this bit over here and it goes down the side, so you can see I've added in some more roads across this area. Now, what is the demand in our city for? It's for jobs, it's for industry or offices, and we're going to put some more offices in. So we built this lovely strip down here, and I really like what we did with the trees on either side. And I'll tell you what, I love putting down trees in this game. It just makes everything look so much better, doesn't it? Let's pick a tree, one of the right size, and not one of these custom assets that I've downloaded either. Something like this. Just if I were to plop this down right in the middle of here, already that roundabout looks 10 times better, right? But we don't want to overdo it. We don't want to slap these everywhere. And those trees that are in the middle, by the way, they were these ones. And I think having a row of trees go down the middle here could be really effective. Is that the one? I like this one. Is it the same one as before? I was looking at it from a different angle. Oh, it was this one I was using before. Aha. Now, this is a custom asset. I've been looking for a few more. At the moment, the Steam Workshop isn't really working. Every time I search for something, it says there's nothing there. And that's when I just select, you know, building with no other things at all. So something's up there. And that one I just felt looked a little bit too similar from tree to tree. However, this other one doesn't have quite that problem. So maybe we'll put a row of those trees going down the middle. And that can go all the way down our motorway here. But what I have been doing is adding in extra trees, just a row of them like we did over on this side. And I tell you what, rows of trees in between each of like the houses, the buildings and the roads, really does work, really looks ever so great. And we definitely want to continue that, which is what we've been doing. But we're now getting to the point where we come to the new area and it needs zoning. Yes, it does. Now, we probably want to put some services around here as well. I've put in the pipes, let's zone up this area. Actually, we'll save that for a park. We'll put a park on the corner there, and these can be saved for services. And then all of this as well can become offices and maybe a park at the end, just over in this space. Possibly, I don't know. But there are some new connections over here as well. And I wasn't able to use the traffic tool to turn off the traffic lights. Let's try again. Click, nothing happens. Right click, nothing happens. If I right click this, I have a load of options. It says left click, toggle traffic lights, right click, reset to default. And didn't seem to be working, so I just clicked remove all traffic lights. Funnily enough, the instance that I did that, my money here went up to 4,000 above. Now it's dropped down to -1,700. I think the city's at a size now where I've neglected its management for a while. And I know some of you watching from episode to episode, you know, point out that I should be doing things to make the city better. I've just been trying to focus on completing this entire thing, which we're doing right now, because the other thing I want to do this episode is finish this area here. I've given myself a little bit more space. I've downloaded some custom buildings like this, which isn't going to go in this area, but it will be something for the future. But we discovered, didn't we, that there were some other buildings around here that we could put into this area. So this place is getting a little bit of a redesign over on this side. We've got more space to do that with, and we're going to put some more things in. Check this out, Silverwind Casino. That looks amazing. That wouldn't really fit in anywhere in our city. Maybe down in this area somewhere it would look okay. But when we build some other areas, we are definitely going to focus on pre-planned layout a little bit more and accommodating for some fancy buildings. But we've got to make this whole city that we have at the moment a lot more functional. So the expansion seems to have stopped around on this side over here, even though there is still some demand. Don't know why, but I'm going to put in those parks, we'll put in some services, I'll get the trees placed down, and I'll bring you back in a bit and we'll see how good it looks. I don't know why I didn't look at this before, but they have unlock requirements. Construct 5 instances of boiler station, fill 1 snow dump, That's something we should be able to do. 200,000 units of snow covering the road. I don't know if that's at once or overall. That might just take time to get to. But these are interesting. They give us something to aim towards. I mean, weekly education expenses. I imagine we have to build a lot of schools and then bump the budget up for a week. But all of this is pretty cool, actually. It's stuff for us to aim for. We probably have that, but we haven't got the trams up and running. And actually, I was thinking of reducing this area a little bit, just over in this corner. What we could put is the tram station around here. That's something I completely forgot about. I think my original plan was actually to put it down in this area. So now we need to find a spot where the tram station might be. It could actually be over here in this area, which is going to be our utility area, but we can't sort of like buy anything yet. And I could probably unlock that with a mod now. But looking for mods on Steam Workshop doesn't seem to be working at the moment. Okay, this is just looking stunning right now. So what I did is, oh yeah, installed like a few more assets. Couldn't really quite find the ones that I wanted to use. But these bushes are all right. I just wish you could put them down with a brush a lot easier. But anyway, selected like four different types of trees and just sort of placed them randomly down the side here so we have a much more overgrown effect. Now this starts down here and goes across the entire area all the way down to here, which is really cool. So when you're sort of in here looking down the street, you can just see loads of trees on one side, which looks great. Then on the opposite side, we've got all of these just sort of evenly spaced out from one another, and it looks real good just across here. And there's also a little walkway bridge to get across to the other side, which I think looks real nice. And I was just able to position like some larger trees right here so that they didn't So the leaves didn't go into the paths. Look at that little cyclist using it to get about. That's good to see. And put in like a little path over here. There's, yeah, a few bits and bobs here and there that I've been doing. The details is all in the details. And yeah, the city's looking pretty good. So there is something that I want to do over here. We're pretty much done with this. We're going to move on to public transport next. We'll work on this over time. I think we're going to need to unlock more things first. But one of those things, if I was a little bit more prepared here, that would help. Construct 5 instances of boiler station. Now, we have built these things, and the boiler stations are the alternatives, and we've got to build 5 of them. Now, they cost. I've just realized how much money I've lost. Is that from placing down trees? Were some of them like expensive? Where did all that money go? Maybe it was one of these buildings that I built. How much do these cost anyway? 60,000. All right, so we've got enough to build 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Bam. And now we should have unlocked something over here. I think, yes, look at that. We've got the ice hockey arena. 4,800 a week. That's going to cut right into our budget. We just spent a ton of money as well. And that is probably going to be a nice little spot for it right there. What do you reckon? Bam. Let's remove the view so we can see the building. I like the roof. It's all snowed over, though. That looks pretty awesome. That fits into this area quite well, actually. And I think once we get more buildings in, you know, various places, filling these gaps in with trees will really make it look good. So we should definitely destroy all of these now that we've built that, because they are pretty much useless to us. By the way, I turned off the dam as well. That thing was costing me like 4 grand a week, which was crazy, crazy stuff. And yeah, we could actually turn this off and just leave it there since it's so expensive. That really is a lot of money, isn't it? Anyway, it looks like I've got some management to do now because we're hemorrhaging money. And I want to do public transport next. So yeah, I think I'm going to turn that off temporarily and we're going to work on public transport. Well, I was about to start the search for a place to put the tram depot and like literally my eyes were just drawn down to this space and I'm like, that's almost perfect. Let's destroy this part of the road. Let's bring it out. Tram line, there we go. I like to use this tool for the long roads so you get them nice and sort of curvy to some extent. Let's bring it down to about here and then go a little bit closer to the shoreline. We're gonna have to jump up a fair bit here. Oh yeah, I remember now, this is actually part of that, so that's why it came through so much. Right, because otherwise, you know, you're gonna bump into that. Okay, so if we go with, actually let's go just a touch higher, like that. It raises up the ground, which I quite like sometimes. Doesn't always look so good. Now I'm struggling to squeeze that in, but I know I can find a way. Let's just say that's going to be our road. Then we could put the tram depot right here, I reckon. Let's have a look. How do we buy it again? I have completely forgotten. No, it's going to be in the transport tab, and then we've got to go to tram. Excellent, right. And it shows you all the different tram roads as well. Oh, right. Some of these don't appear in the other menu because they're tram only. Ah, that's good to know. Okay. Wasn't aware those were available, and look at that. Space already occupied. Okay. But it's very close, isn't it? I just need to move this out a little bit further. Man, I love the look of the city when the time changes. It's really great. Also, looks like there's some problems. Again, I'm just sort of neglecting at them. Let's throw money at it, which is actually something we're running out of. We have certainly got to sort this out at some point. I've had me fun just building without consequence for a while. As I said, fine-tuning is to come. Check this out. So a couple of little office buildings here. Throwing down some trees around this and maybe a park on the side of the road is going to make it look real good. So that area will all get tidied up, and then I'll probably link it round to here with lots of trees. So, you know, just another part of it looks finished. Look at this. It's gorgeous. Man, the trees make so much of a difference. And they really do give it that complete feeling, didn't they? I reckon, you know, we're looking for sight down the middle here. Man, I get distracted easy looking at the sea. I reckon some of those bushes actually might be the ones to go for, just every so often like that. And they're really not too evasive, are they? And then I could go through... I reckon that'll work. I'm going to come back to that idea. What was it? Bush number 6. Okay, number 6. We'll remember you for later. What we want to do right now, though, is look at the tram lines. And what I've gone around and done is put in some paths to connect them, like here. I'm glad we can actually see that. That's very important. Now, we're not going to have a tram stop here. It could be a good idea because people could use it to get to work. Do you know what? I'll just put one there anyway. Okay, so we're going to have two lines, and they're basically going to be mirrored, and they go around in opposite directions. And I have to hover, of course, I have to hover my mouse over here to see it. Right, so we've got a little path there, so we'll have a stop. That's our second stop. Let's count them as we go. We could put a third one just here, but it isn't too much distance. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to put it about midway. So that's stop number... It's there or there. Let's put it... Go on, there you go. Stop number 2. Then it comes back down to the ground over here. So that's going to be stop number 3. Right on the corner there. Down at this end we'll have stop number 4. Again, you can walk to either of these roads. Could probably walk to that one as well. And I think we'll make stop number 5 up here. And the next corner is around there. I'm going to put it there so you can walk around to that one. I might be spacing these out a little bit too much, but I want to have a minimal amount of stops. It's nice and fast. Okay, so that's stop number 6. You can walk to those three. And then over here, the connections are these little paths. So let's have number 7 there. And then we'll have number... I could put one in there as well, but I reckon they'll walk it. Number 8 there, and then there should be... Yeah, one more. We'll put number 9... We'll put it right there so you can go to either, really. Excellent. All right, because without those little paths, there's no connections. The next bit's here. That's going to be number 10. This next bit is nice and easy. Number 11. We're definitely going to have more here because it's quite big. 12. Some of there's a path. 13. 14. And 15. We'll put it up at that one. 16 is there. And... 17 is here. So 17 stops in total. Oh, actually, we've got this bit as well. Right, and they're all connected with paths. So let's put 2. Let's put 1 at either end. 18 is there. 19. And then back around you go. So 19 stops. Now that we've placed all of that down, we should see the trams go. Let's speed it up a little bit. Let's get them out of here. Off you go, trams. Start collecting. Look, people want to go on the tram already. Look, they're queuing up. They love it. Let us on. Oh, they're actually doing it. They're walking around here. Man, it looks so dangerous the way they walk in front of them as they're moving. Excellent. Let's follow them around and let's see if we're getting lots of people waiting. Yes, people are using it. They love it. They want to use the tram. That's amazing. Okay. Right. That's good to see. Lots of people walking around the city. And cyclists. Look at all those cyclists. Awesome. Okay. You need some water. Good thing we're here. Have a little bit of water. Good for you. Right. This is the next stop. And I mean, I was sort of expecting, since they've gone out in front of us, that we would be, you know, like the first ones would have taken all of the people and that would have been it. Man, they love the tram. They can't get enough of it. I mean, this is just an endless crowd of people that want to use the tram, isn't it? Huh. That's brilliant. That's brilliant. As soon as you put down the public transport, the game's like, okay, here we go. Right, and now it goes up here to the next stop, which is probably not going to be as popular. Oh, there it is, all the way up there. Wow, people love this stop as well. Getting some serious crowds. That's absolutely awesome. I'm really happy with this. Okay, let's follow it around. I want to see it go around the whole city. And I want to see all the crowds. Excellent, people want to use it there. It looks like we did a really good job with this then. I might even throw more money at it because we've got loads of crowds of people now. And there might be a bad thing that they're waiting around for too long. Okay. Right, and then another crowd here. Excellent, excellent, excellent. It is all good, isn't it? There's pretty much the same thing to see at each stop. At first there weren't so many people, but then there were crowds. Up in this area it looks a little bit quieter, yeah. Not quite as many people walking out. Now this should help with traffic. Look at how many people are coming out. I really do think this should have an impact on traffic at this point. Now what about these areas? Right, nothing over here in the leisure bit. Let's see if anyone gets dropped off. We are running it fast. Where is the latest one? It's right there. It's just picked up a few more people. And you know what? Another reason we might be seeing bigger crowds is because as the trams come round, they're fuller. They've already filled up with lots of people. Right, let's see if anyone gets out here to go to the leisure. No, no one's interested. Maybe they're going to the commercial area. We'll soon find out. Leisure? Okay, three or four people got off there. And then I think there's just some office stops. Oh, maybe they've gone to work. They work over here. Oh, look at that. A few people got out for work. Where's the next one? Let's try and keep up with it. Oh, wow. That's a massive crowd. That is a massive crowd right there. Fascinating. Okay. Now, we're back round to the beginning. And what I wanted to do here was sort of see the spacing of each of the trams. But we're too far zoomed out. Because you can see they've got a decent space between one another. But I bet you that it's sort of going to end somewhere around here. And there's going to be this massive gap. Like, they're not going to be equally spaced out. Yes, look, crowds of people are being dropped off and they're running out to go shopping. They love it. Let us in. We want to buy stuff. Save the economy. Off they go. There goes my phone. How unprofessional of me. Yeah, that is awesome. Trams, I love them. I'm now going to put another line in that goes to the same places but on the opposite side of the road. Man, this is so cool. It is so cool. Okay, we're going to install another road maintenance depot. We're going to put it over here. This is where we have a snow dump on the opposite side of the road because all the roads are getting snowed over. Actually, looks like all the complaints have gone away now. Oh, there's a few over here. Maybe that'll help. Maybe that was unnecessary. I don't know. Like, I guess when it starts snowing, all the roads are going to snow up and you can't hit them all immediately, but it would suggest it's not too good. I'm going to redo power in a bit, actually, because we've got, like, solar power now. So maybe I'll make like a solar farm somewhere and we can worry less about that. So some of these things will come with like a redesign of the services where we make it look pretty like we did in this area here. I just want to sort of go through and have a look at what we need to do. We need to add more incinerators again. And I think we can say that this area here is kind of done. So maybe we'll need another incinerator area at some point. But again, in the meantime, throw money at it. This is me tweaking the city, by the way. So no, I'm just putting that on the back burner, so to speak. So as far as education goes, the only place we've got education is over in this area. But, you know, we do need uneducated workers in the city. And we said that this area would be the one where we don't educate anyone. So I reckon what we should do is put in another school. What about high schools? Just the one. So we're putting a secondary high school somewhere down here. That's an equal distance. And I'm hoping all of this money that we're throwing at stuff now is going to work out well for us. So we agreed that we would remove buildings with no, like, cause for alarm, I guess. Where would be a nice spot? Just there, those two buildings can go, and we've got a high school down in that area. And bam, they love it. They think it's amazing. This also might lead to people upgrading their homes and getting to the next level, which means possibly more tax money. And then we want this sort of entire area to be educated. So we've got two down there. We should probably put one in the middle somewhere around here. We've got a lot of traffic on that side, so maybe, oh, look, almost just enough space there. Oh, that would have been perfect right there, but guess what's in the way? The tram line! The filthy tram line! We don't like it. No, of course. We love it. I'm going to put it on a corner then and kick some people out. Bam, see you later. There's a new school for you. Everyone loves it. That's great. Still a couple of areas that are a little bit behind, but we'll see how that does. And eventually we want to have a university, right? And I think we'd need to find a little zone to redevelop and make it have its own little campus area as well, which would look pretty cool. So that's education, just improved a little bit. So citizen happiness is pretty good, I'd say. Just need more parks probably to boost that up to the next level. So let's bring out our little park building tool. There was actually something I found that might help. Oh yeah, it was healthcare, right. So I downloaded some custom assets. One of them is a large advanced crematorium, which sounds fantastic. I might build it out the back here. This is going to be another utility area, maybe where there's some incinerators, but there's also the sauna, which costs 400 a week. Supposed to increase healthcare, so Let's look for a spot where it's not so great. Down in this area, it looks a little bit behind. And there's a couple of buildings here. Let's put it right there. And, right, what sort of benefit does it provide? Because the roads haven't gone green, but it's increasing, like, the value of housing around here, isn't it? I think it's affecting it like leisure would. Actually, no, that's the average health. It's just affecting health. Interesting. But probably doesn't help with emergencies. So here's another area that looks a little bit behind. Let's go. There's some small buildings here, so let's replace one of those and put it right in there. Excellent. Now they're all happy. Now this area over here has not got a lot of healthcare, so this is definitely in need of another building. Let's chop it down into that little spot, and there you go. Have some health, and we should see the average health pop up, as well as perhaps some buildings upgrading to the next level. Feel free to do that. Look at that. Look at those little arrows popping up. Excellent. All right, so where were we anyway? We were going to do parks. We're going to do leisure next and just check on that. So you can see why commercial happiness is lower. There's quite a few spots. At this point, I'll probably do that just in between recording. Let's breeze quickly through all of the different things so you can see what's happening here. Oh, and how does this work as well for levels? Is it the darker, the higher? Let's click on that building, level 4. That one, almost level 4. Do we have anything very pale? That one, perhaps? Level 3. Okay, the darker the better. Interesting. So that's going to be a useful tool for me, going around here and looking at all these different industries and what. Okay, okay. Yeah, so traffic in the city, by the way, really good. But you can see still maybe a little bit of issues around here. But red just means a lot of cars go through it. Not always that it's an issue as such. I think the biggest issue is a lot of traffic comes through here that just wants to go out and down across this way, and there's a lot of traffic that comes around this side that wants to cut across and go down this road. So sometimes you see it back up there. Otherwise though, I mean, the majority of it is green. There's no major backups. This area here may be a little bit much, but it's doing okay. It's doing all right. And I think our city is actually pretty well managed at this point. We just need to fine tune everything. So noise pollution's all right. Well, to the extent that it doesn't terribly overlap into residential areas too much. In fact, there is quite a bit of it sort of going around the place. It's these busy roads that we got going through some of our important areas. It's all a little bit too close together probably for that. So fire safety. Here's one that definitely needs some work. We have, yeah, lots of vulnerable spots. And to be fair, a fire station would probably be better than building lots of smaller ones. 560 to 1,400, its range is really, really good. Yeah, so why don't we take care of fire and parks next? I'll do that and show you the result. So some areas like this one are real stubborn about being happy about the amount of leisure there is. Hey, we could put a little park right there on the corner. Bam! Right at the entrance. And yeah, just going around finding little spots basically everywhere. I'll probably do this a little bit more. As you can see, this area could probably do with it as well. But the income really sort of shot up for a while there. And then I think I sort of overstepped the mark by putting in a few more fire stations and police stations. Like there's one here now as well, and I put a couple of things down here. Before there, we were up to 8,000, so I think the city now is generally going to be a lot better. What was the one we were looking at? Happiness? Over here? Yep, residential's gone up. Commercial's a bit stubborn, but the rest are really good. That probably means my mayor rating thing is good. Where is that? Is that still a thing? I think that's just the happiness meter is what I'm remembering that used to be. So yeah, overall looking all right. We haven't got a massive increase. It's now jumped up to 6,000, but we do have more things to refine, like energy. The budget is full on this, which is not got to be efficient. Also, now that we've covered up healthcare a bit, we could probably drop this down. This was here to cover a death scare again, wasn't it? So now that we've improved that, we can, I wish you could just set them both to 100 with like a click of a button. There we go. All right, so let's look at perhaps a location for a solar farm or something like that. Do you know what? We're not going to do that just yet, because I need to look into some mods to just, you know, now give us access to everything. So I want to do this little bit over here with some utilities, and maybe that's where we choose to squeeze in some power stations as well. But this area down here, I've now sort of finished decorating with trees, and I thought what we'd do is just spam a lot of different types and have a little bit of an overgrown feel over here. When you're zoomed out, it's not quite there, but when you zoom in, you definitely get a sense of it. And, you know, the tram depot's just hidden away in here. And then there's yeah, this it sort of spreads out a little bit into where the buildings are and just kind of disappears. And I think it looks great. It does. And look at our income. Oh, it was at 11 a minute ago. Now it's down to 8. It's definitely doing better though. And I was just wondering if we could tax more now. Is our city better? Is it good enough? I've just noticed the whole time these have been on 9%. They should be on 11. And there's me thinking about bumping it up to 12, which we will try. We will try. Maybe I'll do that in between episodes or something, because it'll be a little bit of an experiment, you know. Put it up to 12, sit back, relax, see how it goes. Yeah, so we've got some issues here and there. What are these ones? Not enough educated workers. Interesting, because we just increased our education a little bit. Maybe we need a university. Also, why isn't the auto bulldoze mod doing its thing? I don't know. Trams have been a massive success, and we've got them running on both sides, which is something I neglected to mention earlier. There are, of course, some busier points than others, but people are using them. It's really good. And what we should do is just check out these statistics here. We are looking at 42 per week. Which one is it? 19 per week. That can't be right. Oh, there, that's tourists. 662 per week. I mean, it kind of looks like a lot more when there's these massive crowds at some of the stops. But there you go. It clearly made a difference, though, because the city is running smoother. Our money is up. This fluctuates a lot. It was at 12 a moment ago, and then it drops back down. I need to keep my eye on some of the statistics here and see what's causing these fluctuations. Anyway, let's have a look at how we're doing. We haven't really increased too much for a while. We sort of stalled. That's fair enough. We've been doing lots of tweaking. I'm just going to flick through these so you can see how we're doing. I think we should do this every so often. The city budget, obviously, they're skyrocketing. And the treasury lost a lot of money in a short amount of time to something. I forget what it was that we built. Influx, this is all just interesting stuff. Death rate. Employment percentage. Interesting that that's plummeted its way down and available jobs is still going up. I'm not quite sure what that means, but education's back on the rise. There's more students around. We got more tourists than ever. We got tourist tax income. We got happiness there at an all-time high, and there are residential areas, our commercials and our industrial and offices. You can sort of see where they're all at. Yeah, cool. So prisoners, oh, we've had a spike of prisoners. Fascinating. And cyclists on the down there, possibly because of the trams. Yeah, anyway, that's going to be it from me this episode. Do hope you're enjoying it. I'm having a fantastic time with this series. If you have, leave a like on the video, and I'll see you in the next one. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.